love movies that are about world creation, and this is a world creation top to bottom.
The maze walls, the grievers, the glade, there's just many, many visual aspects to this story. And with Wes's immense knowledge of computer graphics and visual effects, it's just a perfect match.
It's fun to go through the visual effects side of things and start really exploring what we can possibly do so we can really kind of use our imaginations and create stuff that we weren't even intending up front.
The glade is this area surrounded by a giant stone maze where these boys have to learn how to survive.
I'm happy to say that there is not a lot of green screen in this movie. There's a lot of extension work, but our glade was a real location. It was its own little world.
This is a great spot to look out onto the glade and see what's going on. Across the way, you see our gates. That's the main entrance into the maze. The set piece that we built stands about 20 feet tall, although in the film, our walls will be about 100 feet tall. And to get an idea of how tall that is, the treetops that you see behind the wall are about 80 feet, so just a little above that.
And then outside those walls, we go into this grand world of the maze.
In the movie, we have a lot of maze, and of course, we're very limited as to how much we can actually build and create. The walls of the actual maze in the story range from 80 to 100 feet tall. We were limited as to the height that we could build on our stage and allowing enough room for lighting up above. So visual effects will extend them.
I knew that Wes Ball was the perfect guy when I saw his short film, Ruin, which the cinematography, the angles, the music, everything about that just seemed to fit the Maze Runner perfectly.
I'm most comfortable in the VFX world. I'm used to working in a world of frames, whereas in the movie, you're working in the world of minutes. So while most of the scenes, I'll have a storyboarded out. When you get there on the day with live action, throw it out. You can't turn the camera over there because of something over there, or blocking doesn't work this way, or the light's going down, you can't shoot this way. So you have to kind of think on your feet, and sometimes that's the best stuff that we come up with. The big thing I'm trying to do visually is distinguish the sort of sections of the maze, essentially. So this is what I'm calling the narrows. It's the kind of typical places like this,
right?
You know, that you can get lost in, is what everyone's kind of thinking of as a maze. And then I got something called the inner ring, which is basically this. These huge, massive spaces, like a kid this big. The maze is not only one level. There's actually several levels that actually move around, almost like cliff face ideas. And these are the blades. So a whole section of maze that is just arranged with these like things that start closing off on them. And they have to race down as it's slice them in half or something, you know?
See, that's such another good example of something that, yes, it's not literally in the book, but it so captures the spirit and tone of the book. I think that's what a movie should do, is add to the experience of reading the book. I think that is a perfect example.
Cool. It's good. You heard it.
Right here, we've set up kind of what the top of the walls will look like. Some walls go hundreds of feet high, and some of them are shorter. And we got the big surround blue screen, which is really cool. And they set up these blocks and walls, and they made these gaps. I get to jump them, running away from imaginary griever, who you just have to also keep in mind all the time that he's there, barreling down on you.
Grievers are these mechanical monsters that have been made by the scientists who are overseeing this experiment, and they are our villains.
Grievers are scary as hell, horrible looking things.
These eyes, and they turn off, you know what I mean? So, but you don't see them when they're not on, but it's just more mechanics and stuff because it's biomechanical. I wanted to try to do the best we could to capture sort of what James Dashner described in the book, but I wanted to go really freaking scary.
His ideas of what the grievers look like compared to what's described in the book immediately made me see the movie in a whole new light.
I wanted to make something that was gonna terrify people and give people nightmares. That's the stuff that got me when I was a kid. they evolve, and Wicked has attached the tail to them. And then that's what will start, you know, pulling these kids around, stuff like that.
First, when I came here, I saw two guys in blue suits. I thought I was coming to like the Swan Lake performance, but no, they're actually the Grievers. So you'll see guys dressed in all blue suits to match the screens, and they're the Grievers. So what's gonna happen is every movement that they're doing is gonna be enhanced by visual effects. It helps us because like when we're running, we're really running and they're trying to catch us.
Hey, what's up? My name is Greg. I am one of the stunt performers here on The Maze Runner, and I'm standing in as one of the Grievers today. As you can see here, we do a lot of blue screen work, so that's the reason that I'm dressing in this blue suit, so that is easier in post-production for them to wash us out and to replace us with the actual Grievers for the film. Once we get suited up, we'll also cover our face with this mask. And we've got protective gear like knee pads, chest protectors, and a shield on our helmet so that when they're attacking us with the spears, everybody's safe, the safety first. And we're off to set.
It's not lost on me how unusual I think my experience has been. Fox has kind of let me do my thing. It's crazy, so. It's been fun so far.
I think my favorite days were shooting nights in the Glade. Feels like you're having an adventure while you're making an adventure.
This world, the maze and the Glade, provide for a great cinematic experience.
I would have loved this movie as a kid because it's a fun story and it's constantly entertaining.
My fans are extremely passionate, which I love, and I really, really feel strongly that they are going to love this movie.